we want to determine which of the following tables represent functions. A function is a relation in which every input has exactly one output. So looking at these tables, the x values will be the inputs and the y values will be the outputs. So if these tables are functions, we could say that every x value must have exactly one corresponding y value. If this is not true, the table would not be a function. So we want to analyze these tables and make sure every x value has exactly one corresponding y value. So if we take a look at this first table, notice that the input of 2 occurs twice with two different outputs. Here we have an input of 2 with an output of 3, and here we have an input of 2 with an output of negative 1. This does not satisfy the definition of a function because the x value of 2 actually has two different outputs or two corresponding y values. Therefore, this would not be a function. To help visualize this, it's often helpful to show the relationship between x and y using mapping, which means we put the set of inputs here, or the domain here, and the set of outputs, or the range here, and then draw arrows to show each input with the corresponding output. So notice our inputs would be 2, negative 1, negative 4, and 5. We would not list 2 twice. So we have 2, negative 1, negative 4, and 5. And the outputs are the y values. So we have 3, 4, 0, negative 1, and 7. So when the input is 2, here the output is 3. So we show that relationship by drawing an arrow from 2 to 3. When the input is negative 1, the output is 4. And we'll often say negative 1 maps to 4. So we could say negative 4 maps to 0. But notice how 2 also maps to negative 1. So we draw another arrow from 2 to negative 1. And then 5 maps to 7. So notice that 2 has two outputs, one here and one here, and this is the reason why this is not a function. Now let's take a look at the second table. Notice that none of the inputs here repeat themselves, therefore there's no way every x can have more than one corresponding y value. So this will be a function, but we'll also map it to illustrate it better. So again, we'll put the inputs or the elements or numbers in the domain here, and then we'll put the elements or the numbers in the range here. So the inputs would be 4, negative 3, 1, 2, 5. And notice there is some repetition in the outputs. There's only three outputs, negative 5, negative 2, and 0. Now let's go ahead and show the mapping. With an input of 4, the output is negative 5. So 4 maps to negative 5. Negative 3 maps to negative 2. 1 also maps to negative 2. 2 also maps to negative 2. And 5 maps to 0. Now this does look strange because we have three arrows all pointing to negative 2 in the range, but notice how every input or every value here does have exactly one output, even though at times they do have the same output. So because every x has exactly one y, this is a function. Now let's take a look at one more example here. The first thing we should notice in this table is that the input of negative 1 does occur twice. So negative 1 does have two outputs or corresponding y values. Therefore, again, this table is not a function. And let's go ahead and map this as well. So the inputs are 0, negative 1, 4, and 2. Again, we do not list negative 1 twice. Then the outputs will be 3, 4, 0, negative 1, 1. So 0 maps to 3, negative 1 maps to 4, 4 maps to 0, 2 maps to negative 1, and then negative 1 maps to 1. So from negative 1 we have another arrow going from negative 1 to positive 1. So again, because this input of negative 1 has actually two outputs, this table does not represent a function. I hope you found these examples helpful.